Hello, good morning. Thank you for joining us today again. Open Heavens is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insights to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Sunday, the 16th day of May, 2021. And our topic for today is, You Can Be Rich and Righteous. Let us pray. Lord God Almighty, we come before you today again to learn of you. We open up our hearts to receive from your throne of grace. We ask that your word would come to us today with simplicity and power in the name of Jesus. Amen. Praise God. You are welcome back. Our memory verse for today is from the book of Proverbs chapter 8 verse 18. Proverbs 8 verse 18 reads, Riches and honor are with me, yea, durable riches and righteousness. Proverbs 8 verse 18. And our scripture reading for today is from the book of Malachi chapter 3 verse 10 to 12. Malachi 3 verse 10 to 12 reads, Bring ye all the tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in mine house, and prove me now herewith, saith the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven, and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. And I will rebuke the devourer for your sakes, and he shall not destroy the fruits of your ground, neither shall your vine cast her fruit before the time in the field, saith the Lord of hosts. And all nations shall call you blessed, for ye shall be a delightsome land, saith the Lord of hosts. God bless his word in Jesus' name. Amen. Our Father in the Lord tells us today that many children of God have misconceptions about prosperity. Some think that being a Christian means that they have to be poor, forgetting that God himself said in Proverbs 8 verse 18, Riches and honor are with me, yea, durable riches and righteousness. Imagine God, our Father, having the possession of riches and righteousness. This revelation counters the notion that you cannot be righteous and rich at the same time. Today, I decree that the power to get wealth shall come upon you in Jesus' name. Those people who think that wealth is alien to God run after the devil, and he deceives them into thinking that he has wealth. The devil tried this with Jesus in Luke chapter 4 verse 6 to 7, but our Savior knows better. The truth is that only God can give you power to get wealth. Deuteronomy 8 verse 18. He blessed Abraham, Isaac and Jacob in their generations, as we see in Genesis 22 verse 15 to 18, 26 verse 12 to 14, and 32 verse 9 to 10. When Jabez cried unto God in 1 Chronicles 4 verse 10, God blessed him greatly. Peter, the struggling fisherman, encountered the King of Glory at the Lake of Gennesaret, and suddenly he became prosperous, looking for additional hands to help him gather his bountiful harvest. Luke chapter 5 verse 4 to 9. This same God will give you power to get wealth today in Jesus' name. The question now is, how do we get this power to become wealthy? It is simple. Always worship the Lord with fear and trembling. Commit to meditating on his word. Joshua 1 verse 8, Deuteronomy 28 verse 1. You must also not forget to be like him in your dedication to service. God would only give his riches and honor to diligent people. You must never be lazy or idle. Furthermore, you must keep his commandments in the areas of tithe, offering, and first fruits. Remembering the needy, the widow and the orphans. Proverbs 19 verse 17. Finally, you must live and spend your income prudently, because Proverbs 21 verse 17 says, He that loveth pleasure shall be a poor man. We shall be wise in the mighty name of Jesus. God bless his word to us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise God. Someone once said, if wealth would not draw you closer to God, poverty would not do so either. Poverty is not equated to spirituality. God delights in blessing his people. He wants to see them live the good life. Our Father in the Lord explains that some think that being a Christian means that they have to be poor. The scripture tells us the kind of God that we serve. Psalm 35 verse 27 says, Let them shout for joy and be glad that favor my righteous cause. Yea, let them say continually, Let the Lord be magnified, which hath pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. So the prosperity of God's servant brings him pleasure. There is no two ways about that. When we check through the scripture also, we can see countless numbers of people who walked with God and enjoyed prosperity. We have Abraham, Isaac, Jacob, just to mention a few of them. In fact, Isaac was so prosperous, the Bible tells us that at a point, the Philistines were envious of him, a whole nation envious of one man. That is how much God intends to bless us. These men also had the unquestionable testimony that they walked with God. Abraham was called a friend of God, and he was also an epitome of God's blessing upon a man. Praise God. So now we've settled the fact that God can make us rich while we still maintain righteousness. We'd move on to see, like our Father and the Lord has already described, how do we get this power to become wealthy? How does this power to obtain wealth come? He tells us that we must learn to worship the Lord. We must commit to meditating on His word. We must also ensure to be like Him in our dedication to service, because God would not commit His wealth to any lazy man. We must also be faithful in our obedience to tithing, offering and first fruits. We must remember the needy, the widows and the orphans, and also learn to be prudent in our spendings. Our God Himself is not a waster. The Lord Jesus gathered 12 baskets full of bread after the miracle of multiplication. So we too must demonstrate prudence. And we trust God today that we would enjoy His abundant riches in righteousness in Jesus' name. Amen. We'd bow our heads now and pray. We'd say, Father, please give me the power to get wealth, and I will become a channel of blessing to the world in the name of Jesus. Let my life become a source of blessing to others. Let me be a conduit of carrying Your favor. Let lives be transformed because You transformed my life. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Lord Jesus, we are glad to be before You. Thank You for revealing to us Your thoughts and intents for us. We declare from this day that we are blessed to be a blessing. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. Praise the Lord. In our Bible in 1 year reading plan for today, we read from the book of Mark chapter 4 and chapter 5. Praise God. We are glad that you joined us today. God bless you. If you love to speak to someone or to receive updates like this daily, please send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80 986 11226. Bless someone also by sharing this with them. Have a blessed day in Jesus' name. Amen.